First up, Game of Thrones is over, but there's still news out there. For instance, according to one of the film's stars, Dwayne Johnson, Hobbs & Shaw has officially wrapped production. From CBR.com, Johnson announced the production wrapping with a post on Instagram saying, "That's a 100% official wrap on production for the beast known as Hobbs & Shaw." He goes on to thank all the cast and crew that worked on the film, as well as all the fans. In the image he posted, Johnson is on a motorcycle of his own private collection. Hobbs & Shaw is a spin-off of the Fast & Furious film series. It follows Luke Hobbs, played by Johnson, and Deckard Shaw, played by Jason Statham, as they go up against the villainous Brixton, played by Idris Elba. Fans of the series also have Fast & Furious 9 to look forward to in 2020. Fast & Furious Presents Hobbs & Shaw arrives in theaters August 2nd. Next up, Captain Marvel didn't make huge money this week, and in fact it didn't even crack the top 10 at the May 17-19 domestic box office. But from last Sunday to today, its domestic total jumped $2 million, now totaling $1.125 billion. All told, the past week or so has been enough to push Captain Marvel's worldwide gross above two competitors, 2011's Transformers Dark of the Moon and 2003's The Lord of the Rings Return of the King. Captain Marvel rests at position 22. However, that will most likely change as Star Wars The Rise of Skywalker, Toy Story 4, The Lion King, and Frozen 2 hit theaters later this year. In other box office news, John Wick Chapter 3 topped Avengers Endgame this weekend, and Avengers Endgame overtook Avatar at the all-time domestic box office. Next up, Kevin Costner is part of a group of stars this year that you once never would have imagined seeing in a TV series. But Costner not only took that plunge with Yellowstone from Hell or High Water and Sicario writer Taylor Sheridan, but also tested the streaming waters with the Netflix film The Highwaymen. When asked if The Highwaymen would have been successful with a theatrical release, the actor said the following, "I don't think so. I think it will be received by an audience on Netflix because of that, and the understanding we were after something special. But getting people out of their homes? I don't think that movie makes it. So what would happen is, they have to make it for such a low amount. You're going to lose the production value, and lose the premium viewing experience." Costner will appear again on TV in season 2 of Yellowstone, airing on Paramount Network on June 19th. Next up, it looks like more food porn is on the way via Netflix, so get ready to feel very hungry, as it is being reported that both Chef's Table and Somebody Feed Phil have been picked up for new seasons. From Vulture.com, Netflix used the FYSEE Food Day to announce new episodes of Chef's Table and Somebody Feed Phil, hosted by Everybody Loves Raymond's executive producer Phil Rosenthal. Chef's Table will return with two new seasons next year, and Somebody Feed Phil will be back for one. Rosenthal's show is his second food-related show after his PBS series I'll Have What Phil's Having. The streaming service also announced a new show, The Chef Show, co-hosted by Chef Roy Choi and Jon Favreau. Favreau and Choi worked together previously on Chef, Favreau's food truck film for which Koji Barbecue food truck owner Choi served as a consultant. Choi's Koji truck was featured on Anthony Bourdain, Parts Unknown, Ugly Delicious, and the aforementioned I'll Have What Phil's Having. Next up, John Hannah, Corey Johnson, and Oded Ferrer will star in Layer, billed as a socially conscious horror movie about an LGBT family embroiled in one man's attempt to prove the existence of the supernatural. From Variety, the trio all appeared in the successful franchise The Mummy, and their new picture goes into production later this year. The film follows self-proclaimed occult expert Dr. Stephen Caramore, played by Johnson, who ekes out a living debunking claims of possession, haunting, and anything supernatural for a quick buck. When a friend, Ferrer, accused of murder, claims he was possessed by a demon, Caramore has to test his own beliefs. Hannah stars as his lawyer. Caramore litters an apartment with cursed items, outfits it with surveillance equipment, and rents the place to an unsuspecting family, setting off a chain of supernatural events. Production gets underway in LA in September. And finally, Keanu Reeves is enjoying revisiting his characters of late with John Wick Chapter 3 and Bill and Ted Face the Music. Now, the actor would like to continue this trend with another one of his past roles. MovieWeb.com reports, the actor would love to come back to the world of Constantine. Excitement was high on Constantine before it hit theaters, but that quickly faded away. However, Keanu Reeves would like to come back to the role. Reeves has been talking a lot about past roles over the past several weeks while out promoting John Wick Chapter 3 Parabellum. Constantine is on his radar. He explains, "I've always wanted to play John Constantine again. I just love that world too. And I love the character. I just had a blast playing a character and playing in that world. Maybe now would be a good time to revive Constantine. DC and Warner Brothers may already have plans to bring the character back, though it has not been confirmed at this time." Keanu Reeves just scored the number one movie at the box office with John Wick Chapter 3, which is also the franchise's best ever opening at $57 million. The fourth movie is already being mapped out. And that will do it for today's installment of the Movie News Feed.